In this video, we're going to take a look at multiplying and dividing integers, and we're going to do that across a CRA progression. Recall that C stands for concrete, R stands for representational, and A stands for abstract, and we're going to work across that entire progression in this video. So when we think about multiplication and we think about the way students learn to multiply, if they saw 3 times 2, young kids, second graders, third graders, are asked to interpret this as 3 groups of 2. That's the language that teachers use to introduce multiplication, 3 groups of 2. So if we wanted to model this for integers, we would say that this is 3 groups of 2, and in that case it's a positive 2, so I would do a group of 2, a group of 2, and a group of 2, and that would give me 3 groups of 2, or altogether that would give me 6. So 3 groups of 2 of positive 2 would give me 6. We're not going to change that definition just because we're working with integers. We're going to stick with it. So if we altered this problem then to be 3 times negative 2, it's still 3 groups. The only thing that's changed is what we have groups of. So instead of a positive 2, this time we have groups of negative 2. So if I wanted to model that, 3 groups of negative 2 would look like this. There's 1 group of negative 2, a second group of negative 2, and here are 3 groups of negative 2. So 3 groups of negative 2 give me a product of negative 6. Okay, so 3 groups of 2 or 3 groups of negative 2. Where it gets interesting is when the first number is negative. Let's say that this was negative 4 times 2. Now we can't do negative 4 groups. What we probably want to do intuitively is utilize a commutative property and say, let's think about this as 2 groups of negative 4. But we can't do that yet because that's considered abstract work. And students aren't ready for that if this is an introductory level to multiplication with integers. So again, we want to model exactly what's given to us. So how do we handle that negative sign? Well, technically, what we will do is we will factor off that negative 1. And we will treat this as negative 1 times 4 times 2. So now we can still do our 4 groups of 2 like we used to. And then the way we handle the negative is to do the opposite. So we would interpret negative 4 times 2 as the opposite of 4 groups of 2. And the way that that would look when we were modeling is we would do 4 groups of 2. So that's 4 groups of positive 2. Which would give me a positive 8. But we want the opposite. And so the opposite is going to be a negative 8. Okay, so negative 4 times 2 we are going to interpret as the opposite of 4 groups of 2. And the reason we can do that is because we're factoring off that negative 1 off of the negative 4. If we wanted to look at another example, if we had 2 negatives that we were multiplying, let's say negative 3 times negative 4, we would interpret this as the opposite of 3 groups of negative 4. So again, what we're thinking about is factoring off that negative 1 and then multiplying 3 times negative 4. So we're going to handle 3 groups of negative 4 and then we'll do the opposite. So we'd have 3 groups of negative 4. So that would be a group of negative 4. There's 1. There's 2 groups of negative 4. And here is 3 groups of negative 4. So 3 groups of negative 4 gives me a negative 12, but we want the opposite of that, which would be a positive 12. And the same is going to hold true, the same language will hold true when we work with the representation. So the way that we would draw this, instead of using manipulatives, we would still say the opposite of 3 groups of negative 4, but we would draw 3 groups of negative 4, which would give us negative 12 But we want the opposite, and what teachers tend to do is circle that and put a big plus sign over it. Or I've seen teachers say that this is negative 12, but we want the opposite, which is going to make that a positive 12. So let's take a look at a couple more representations for multiplication. If we had a problem like 2 times negative 3, we would interpret this as two groups of negative 3. So this would be two groups of negative 3, which would give us negative 6. If we had negative 3 times 1, this would be the opposite of three groups of 1. So we would do three groups of 1, which would give us a positive 3. But we don't want that. We want the opposite, which would give us a negative 3. And so we can see here how we can generalize rules. If I have groups of negatives, this would be groups of negatives, my product will be negatives. Here I had a negative times a positive, which is the opposite of groups of positives. So the opposite of groups of positives would also be negatives. If we tried another problem where we had 2 times 4, this is saying two groups of 4. So I'm going to have a group of positive 4 and another group of positive 4. And so two groups of positive 4 is going to give me a positive 8. Or another problem like negative 3 times negative 1 would be the opposite of three groups of negative 1. So we're going to do three groups of negative 1, which would be negative 3. But we don't want negative 3, we want the opposite, which would be a positive 3. Okay? So in both of these cases, here we have a positive times a positive. We would interpret that as groups of positives would give us positives. Or a negative times a negative would be the opposite of groups of negatives. The opposite of negatives are positives. And so we can use these models, whether concrete or representation, to establish the abstract rules that when we multiply the same sign, the product is positive, and when we multiply different signs, the product is negative. Division is going to work the same way, it's just the inverse. So if the model says that A times B is equal to C, then I interpret A groups of B was going to give me C as the product. Division then, we would say if A times B is equal to C, I could divide both sides by A. And that tells me that B must be equal to C over A, or the total group divided into this many groups. Remember, A indicated how many groups you had, and B was what was in each group. So if we think about the same meaning for these variables, C is the total number of items, and we're going to divide that into a certain number of groups, then what is in each group will be the quotient. So if we have a problem like negative 6 divided by 2, we interpret that as negative 6. We interpret that as negative 6, and we want to divide that into two groups. When we divide that into two groups, what's in each group? 3 negatives or negative 3. Same kind of problem, except we'll put the negative sign in the denominator. So if we had, let's say, 6 divided by negative 2, remember now the denominator is what tells us our groups, how many groups. Well, we can't do 6 things into negative 2 groups. Negative 2 groups doesn't make sense. So officially, what we're doing is factoring off that negative again and handling the 6 divided by 2. And so we're going to do the opposite of 6 into 2 groups. Just like we did with multiplication, we're going to use the language of the opposite. So this would be 6. I show 6 into 2 groups. There are 3 in each group, but I don't want that. I want the opposite, and so that would be a negative 3. Okay, so the same language is going to hold for multiplication to help us with division. And we can also do that with a representation. So if we had negative 8 divided by negative 2. We would interpret this as negative 1 times negative 8 divided by 2. So it would be the opposite of negative 8 into two groups. And again, we interpret it as the opposite because the denominator is negative. So we would say negative 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, into two groups. There are negative 4 in each group, but I want the opposite, so that's going to be a positive 4. So the opposite of negative 8 into two groups gives us 4 in each group. Negative 10 divided by 2, we interpret as negative 10 into two groups. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 10 things, and we are going to do two groups. And so there are 5 negatives in each group. Because the numerator is, because the denominator is positive, this is just two groups. Whereas in this problem, the denominator was negative, so it was the opposite of two groups. And so these rules, again, the rules can be generalized from these models. So if we wanted to think about a positive divided by a positive, okay, that would just be a positive into this many groups, how many ever that is. And that would just give us groups of positives. If we did a negative divided by a negative, this would be the opposite of negatives, which would give us positives. If we had a positive divided by a negative, this would be the opposite of positives into groups, which would give us negatives. And if we had a negative divided by a positive, it would just be negatives divided into groups, which would give us negatives in each group. So the language for multiplication carries over into division and can once again be used to establish the rules for why when we're dividing the same signs we get a positive, but when we're dividing different signs we get a quotient that is negative.